Hi guys, it's Ellie. Oh my god.
This case pisses me off. I always get super angry. I always get blocked reading it. I don't even know how my video got deleted. It's literally insane.
Hi guys, it's Ellie. If it's your first time, my name is Ellie Arquette. I am a psychic medium, a spiritual life coach, and founder of Ellie Arquette Cosmetics. Speaking of being a founder of Ellie Arquette Cosmetics, I have a little bit of makeup on. I have some amazing products that are vegan, cruelty-free, organic, lip glosses, lipsticks, skincare, blah, blah, blah. It's on sale for Black Friday till Monday. If you guys are interested, go check it out, ellieorchidcosmetics.com. I mean, my skin is due to the fact that I have amazing products. Go check it out, take advantage of the sale. If you guys wanna book a session with me, go to ellieorchid.com. Please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up.
The devil was after me, the devil was after me, the devil was after me.
The devil deleted my video. I will tell you all about it, and let's get into today's video. Okay, you guys, oh my God. Yesterday I was yelling so much that the neighbors called my landlord, and then my landlord called me, "Are you okay? Because people are hearing you scream." And I was like, yeah, I had done a video and it was deleted and I can't find it. And he was like, oh, okay, I thought somebody was killing you. So that's how angry I was yesterday. You guys don't understand, I'm an Aries with Leo rising and Scorpio moon. When I get mad,
it's really ugly. Like, it's really ugly.
So I couldn't believe it. So what happened was, I had done this epic Thanksgiving video for you guys. I want it to be the super epic, amazing, like long video. I did a introduction of, you know, talking about Brian and Gabby's case. And then I sat down and I did a full on reading on it. And then I did a spirit box session all in one video. It was like 45 minutes, like almost like an hour video. And the content was so epic. Like when I tell you guys it was epic, like it's like an understatement. So much stuff came through with the cards and the spirit box and the fact that it is gone. I cannot recreate that. I cannot replicate that, because that's like in that moment when I was doing the reading and the spirit box session. It's like in that moment. I don't know if that can be repeated. I don't know how I can recreate that, right? So anyways, so what was it? Friday? Yeah, Friday. So Thursday for Thanksgiving, my fucking internet went out. And I had done the video and everything, and I was not able to upload it to YouTube. So it was sitting in my hard drive, right? And I do everything systematically. So like I do my videos, I edit, and then I upload and I tag and I do everything. So it's like ready to go to be published by like 5 o'clock. I'm like sweating, you guys, talking about this. Like that's how I'm so upset. Like I'm still upset over this. It's like Saturday that I'm doing this video for you guys, because somebody gave me the idea, well, then you just tell us what happened. So I'm telling you guys what happened. So basically, as I'm like literally sweating because I'm so like upset about this whole thing. I'm like literally sweating. Let me take my feathers and oh my God. Like I'm literally sweating, you guys. I don't know if you can tell, but so the internet was gone. The internet was gone and I was just so, I actually watched Cleopatra because like my TV wasn't working. Nothing was working because everything's hooked up to the internet. So I watched Cleopatra, which I'll talk about it in a second too. It just kind of reminded me of like twin flame connection. Like it's just toxic AF, right? Like Cleopatra and Mark Anthony were twin flames and they were toxic and the whole thing. I want to talk about it. Like I want to like do a video about maybe when I next do like in my twin flame reading on my Tarot with Messages channel to talk about like epic, I don't know why I keep saying epic, but like all these like historic classic like couples that marry each other and divorce each other and made each other's like lives like hell. Like they're all twin flames, you know what I mean? And they can't get away from each other. It's just like it is what it is. It's like it was really hard to like walk away from your twin. But anyways, so I was watching Cleopatra and I was like, okay, I'm gonna wake up in the morning. They told me they're gonna fix it. So I got up, internet was restored. Now in my mind, I thought that I had uploaded the video that I did for you guys already to YouTube. So it was like great because I do, it's like an automatic thing because like I do my videos, I edit, I upload, it's like ready to go, right? It's like a system. I have a system. I have 4 channels, you guys. I have to have a system, otherwise I'm not gonna remember what the hell I'm doing, right? So in my mind, I thought I had done that, right? But I had not done that. And the video was in my files somewhere. So I got up, I did a vlog, morning coffee morning vlog for my vlog channel. If you guys are interested in that, by the way, check it out. I did a coffee morning vlog swatching all my lipsticks, and then I did a tarot messages with Ellie for my third channel. I did a collective reading for the twin flame energy reading, and then it was like almost 5 o'clock, right? I was editing and I put all those videos up, and then it was like almost 5, right? And I was like, okay, my parents are visiting, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna publish my video, and they're gonna be so stoked because of this video is like so amazing. I went to publish the video. It wasn't on YouTube because I never upload because my internet had crashed, right? And I was like, okay, so I'm just gonna go to my file because I never downloaded it to YouTube, and I guess I forgot to do that. When I went to look for it, it was gone. This has never happened to me. So anyway, that's that part of the story. Now let me tell you guys what I saw. And let me just push back so I can like sit up and put my legs up. Okay, so obviously, as me telling you guys, I don't know if you guys are gonna believe me or not, or if you guys, I don't know. But I'm just gonna tell you the truth, okay, of what happened. The reason I wanted to do a video on Brian Laundry and Gabby is because A, I wanted to, you know, first say like how heartbroken I am over the holidays because I lost my brother to suicide 6 years ago. And I know exactly what it feels like not to have family around you for the holidays, right? So like I wanted to say, you know, we want to pay our condolences to Gabby Petito's family. Like my heart goes out to her and her family. Like I know she's in a good place, but her family is just going to suffer like forever. And it's just so like unnecessary. This beautiful young girl, that her life was taken away, and there's so many like her that this happens because of domestic violence. So I'm really passionate about that, to talk about it and do videos about that, right? And then so somebody sent me this article, and they were like, Ellie, you know, can you please do a video about this? So when I got this, so somebody sent me this thing. It said, Brian Laundry mystery is solved. He died from a self-inflicted gunshot wound to the head, according to CNN. He remains the sole suspect in Gabby Petito's murder. After a massive week-long manhunt, his remains were found on October 20th in the Carlton Reserve near his parents' home in Northport, Florida. Now, the part of that which was confusing to me is like, how were they able to figure out that this was a gunshot? Like it was a gunshot inflicted wound, like he committed suicide basically. If all they found was his jaw blown and some teeth, did they find the skull? And it's like, if they found the skull, like this is October 20th, right? So they found October 20th. So you're telling me like back then they couldn't figure out like a bullet went through his head? Is that what they're trying to tell us? If there was a skull and jawbone and teeth that they found, so you're telling me that they couldn't figure out that there was a gunshot, like a bullet in his skull? They didn't see it? So they're telling us 2 months later that it was a self-inflicted gunshot? That doesn't make any fucking sense, okay? Why is this case so fucked? So I'm just telling you guys some of this stuff, and then I'm gonna tell you guys what I saw. And then I thought to be important to read this shit to you guys. I don't know where I saved this. Oh, it's right here. I want to read you guys the stages of death. I don't know if you guys know this, but I thought this was important to like tell you guys. Okay. So stages of death, moment of death. Number one, the heart stops. Number two, the skin gets tight and gray in color. Number three, all the muscles relax. Number four, the bladder and bowels empty. You like shit and piss yourself, right? Number five, men will get an erection. Okay, girl. Number six, the body's temperature will typically drop to 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit per hour unless outside environment is a factor. The liver is the organ that stays warmest the longest. And this temperature is used to establish time of death if the body is found within that time frame. That's how the coroner can figure out like what time you died based on your liver, okay? After 30 minutes, the skin gets purple and waxy. Number 7, lips, finger, and toenails fade to a pale color or turn white as the blood leaves, right? Number 8, blood pools at the lowest part of the body, leaving a dark purple black stain called livity, okay? Number 9, the hands and the feet turn blue. Number 10, the eyes start to sink into the skull after 4 hours now. Number 11, rigor mortis. Am I saying this right? Rigor mortis starts to set in. Number 12, the purpling of the skin and the pooling of the blood continue. Rigor mortis begins to tighten the muscles for about another 24 hours, then will reserve and the body will return to a limp state. After 12 hours, the body is in full rigor mortis after 24 hours. The body is now the temperature of the surrounding environment. In males, the semen dies. Number 17, the head and the neck are now a greenish blue color. Number 18, the greenish blue color continues to spread to the rest of the body. Number 19, there is a strong smell of rotten meat. Number 20, the face of the person is essentially no longer recognizable. After 3 days, the gases in the body tissues form a large blisters on the skin. Number 22, the whole body begins to bloat and swell grotesquely. This process is speeded up if the victim is in a hot environment or, environment or in water. Now, what's his face? Brian was in water. The reason I want to read you guys this is because there is a possibility that they found his remains the way that they found his remains. So let me continue reading this. So number 22, the whole body begins to bloat and swell grotesquely. This process is speeded up if the victim is in hot environment or in water. So actually it speeds up this process if you're in water and if the air is hot, which is Florida, humidity, blah, blah, blah. Number 24, the skin, hair, and nails are so loose they can be easily pulled off the corpse. 25, the skin cracks and bursts open in many places because of the pressure of internal gases and the breakdown of the skin itself. Number 26, decomposition will continue until body is nothing but skeletal remains, which can take as little as a month in hot climates and 2 months in cold climates. The teeth are often the only thing left years and centuries later, because tooth enamel is the strongest substance in the body. The jawbone is the densest, so that usually also will remain. I wanted to read this to you guys because A, Brian Laundrie's body was in hot weather, in water, and after a month, it is very possible that all that is left is skeletons, like your skull, your jawbone, your teeth. So this part makes sense, right? Like he was found like, so Gabby passed away the end of August and they found him at the end of October, October 20th. So this is possible, right? So now when I sat down and I had talked about this in my previous video, and then I was like, okay guys, in the next segment, I'm gonna do a full on reading about Brian and Gabby. Because I wanted to do a reading on Brian and Gabby separately, and then I wanted to do a spirit box session to see if they were gonna come through. So I wish at least that part of the video could be shown to you guys. I sat down at my table and I was like, I'm gonna do a reading and I'm gonna put the camera just on the cards, right? So you guys can see. As I'm shuffling, the first card that flew out of the deck was the King of Cups, which is Scorpio, which is Brian literally came out like boom out, and basically the cards were showing that he was influenced spiritually, that he has a bad temper. So the Temperance card came out, I remember that. So his card came out, the King of Cups, and then the Temperance card came out. The Temperance card that came out talked about how he had two sides to his personality. One side was this kind of like a calm, collected, logical, cool, nice kind of a person. The other side of him was this fiery nature, and that he had no control over himself when he kind of would go there. Like when he would lose his temper, he had no control over his emotions, were very unstable. So the cards that were coming up, so that card came out, the King of Cups flew out, the first card, which is him, Temperance came out, and then I got the Justice card, which is he got his karma. He got his justice. You guys, he's dead, okay? He got his justice and he got his karma, meaning that because when you take somebody's life, nothing can come close to that. I don't care how many years you're going to stay in prison. I don't know how many, I don't care how many times you're going to get raped. Like once you die, you die. You have no, there's no more of you to spend time with family, friends, kids. Like she never got married. She didn't have kids. She didn't experience any of that. So there's nothing you could do to justify. Like even if he went to prison, even if he went to jail and he was embarrassed in front of his friends and family and on national television for the world to see, nothing would be the same as like him, like, you know, losing his life. The fact that he lost his life and he died, I feel like that's justified. That's the way I think. I don't know what you guys think, but the fact that he died is justified. He needed to die. If you take someone's life, you need to fucking die. That's, you know, I feel like there's nothing that can justify that. Like, I don't want you to go to jail and then as a taxpayer, I have to sit there and pay taxes so you could be fed and shower and have internet and watch TV and play pool and play cards and exercise and then find Jesus and read the Bible. No, fuck that. You need to die. Capital punishment. That's what I think. Disclaimer, this video is for entertainment purposes only, but I'm just telling you guys because it's just fucked up. So the first card that came out was his card, King of Cups, the Temperance, and the Justice card. He got his justice, you guys. He got his karma. His karma is that he died. His karma is that he died. And it is extremely possible, 100%, that his body could have turned into skeletons, because I didn't know when I was researching for the video that you guys didn't get a chance to see that I'm redoing right now by just talking about it. When I read all the stages of death and I'm like, oh my God, this makes sense. Hot weather, water, over a month, you can turn into a skeleton, basically. Basically, that's what it says. Like the stages of death. By the way, don't sign me up for dying. That's just fucking nasty. Yeah, it's like, that's why people are like, you need to get buried or burned because it's like disgusting. It's so disgusting. Anyways, I was like visualizing as I was reading that when I first like researched it and I was like, oh my God, this is so gross. Anyways, so when I did the cards, I can't remember the rest of the card, but basically the reading was like, he got his justice and him and Gabby, towards the end of their reading, both their cards came out together. So Brian and Gabby's card, and then the High Priestess came out. All three like jumped out of the deck, because you guys know how I do my cards. I shuffle and I do this thing where I'm like shuffling until a card like pops out. That's how I read, because I want spirit to like collect the card for me. So when I got the King of Cups, the Queen of Cups, which is Scorpio Pisces, and then the High Priestess. Now the High Priestess does tell us that there are things regarding this case that we still don't know. I don't know how Brian died, but he is dead. Okay, I don't know how he died. I don't know what happened surrounding this case. And I will tell you guys what the spirit box said. So that was the reading. Then I sat down to do the spirit box session and I was like, okay, are they together? Because they came up together. Like I shuffled and shuffled and the three cards that jumped out was the King of Cups, the Queen of Cups, and the High Priestess. And I was like, okay, so it's showing that the High Priestess talks about things that we can't see or know. There's things behind the veil that we just don't know and we can't see. So something is still hidden to us, the public, about this case. What is it? What the fuck is going on? What happened, right? So I did a spirit box session. Now the spirit box session, I was like, is Brian Laundrie being protected? And it came out, he went to Satan. It says Satan in the response. I can't remember what else was said. God, I'm trying to remember what was said. I said, is he dead? And they said again, he had crossed over. He had already crossed over. So this is the third, fourth time that spirit is now telling me that Brian Laundry has crossed over. He is dead, you guys, okay? Like maybe I don't want to believe it or you don't want to believe it, but when spirit is talking to me and telling me he's crossed over, he's dead, okay? So they said that he's crossed over. They said something like Satan basically claimed him. Like Satan basically claimed his soul. What else did it come through? A lot of shit came through and I can't remember right now. Literally I'm trying to remember right now as I'm doing this video. Oh my God. I remember Satan. I remember he crossed over for sure. I remember crossing over because it was like the beginning of the session. Gabby came through. I got really emotional doing the spirit box session because it was Thanksgiving and I was by myself and, you know, I felt lonely and I felt sad and I felt sad. Oh, my brother was here. So when I was doing my session here, when I did my introduction video here in my room, there was this huge apparition that showed up behind me and it was Thanksgiving and I felt like my brother was here and that made me really emotional. When I was doing my introduction, I got all emotional around that time and I didn't know that the apparition was behind me because I'm on camera, I can't see anything. The only time I can see and detect it is when I do, when I'm editing. When I'm editing, when I see orbs and apparitions around me and I'm like, whoa, like at the time, I don't see it. That is what is called an EVP. EVP is an electronic voice phenomenon. You guys, I'm a paranormal expert. I was like featured on TV shows and stuff, okay? So an EVP is like at the time that I'm recording this video, I don't hear anything and I don't see anything. But when I edit, when I stop the recording and I go back to listen and watch, that's when you hear voices, noises, and visual things that at the time you were recording, you did not see or hear. That is what is called an EVP. Electronic voice phenomenon is noises, voices, and orbs and apparitions that are detected during the recording, audio or video, and at the time you don't see it, but then it's imprinted energetically into the device. Meaning your, you know, your cell phone when you're videoing or your camera or your audio. So full on, every time I do, like a lot of times when I'm just doing my makeup here, because I do my makeup videos for my channel, for my vlog channel here, there's apparitions and orbs behind me. It's crazy. They're always here in this bedroom. And also you see it in the living room. Now, when I put the green screen behind me, I don't think you guys can see it unless like the orb is like in front of me, but sometimes I see it too. And I'm tired of like pointing it out because by now people should know like that shit is what's around me. Like I have spirits around me, you know? I have spirits, entities, demons, they're all around me because I'm a medium, you guys. They have to come to me because I'm the only one that can listen to them and hear them and talk to them. They can't go to an average person. That's why they're around me. Because people are like, oh my God, like protect yourself. It's not that I'm not protected. It's the fact that they have to come around me because I'm the only one they can see and hear them. Does that make sense to you guys? That's why they're around me. Anyways, I don't fucking remember the rest of the spirit box session. It was epic. All I know was it was almost like an hour epic video that I did for you guys. And there's apparitions around me that were giant that you guys missed. The cards were amazing. The spirit box was amazing. So spirit box did say, this is like the fourth fucking time. Spirit said, Brian Laundry has crossed over. And Gabby came through. Brian, I don't remember Brian. I think Brian did come through, but I don't remember what he said. I literally don't remember what he said. Like, I don't remember the spirit box session. I just remember the beginning part of it that I was told that he had crossed over and I was like, is something protecting him? I was like, was there an energy that was protecting Brian? And then it came out Satan. Like I literally heard that. So in conclusion, to wrap this video up, Brian did die. It is possible that his body turned to skeletons after a month of being in hot water and hot weather or humidity or just water and humidity outside or hot weather. And the only thing that I don't understand is how they know about the gunshot. So did he die? Is he dead and he's crossed over? Yes. But But the circumstances around his death are mysterious. We still don't know what the fuck happened. Who killed him? Did he kill himself? I doubt that. I honestly don't think he killed himself. And I may have to do a spirit box session on my fourth channel and just do a spirit box session on him and just be like, how did you die? Who killed you? What happened to you? You know, why didn't you just come forward? Like, what was going on? Oh, I remember something else. The other thing that I remember seeing when I was doing the cards was that the lawyer was getting paid a lot of money from the family. So I don't know if the family... Disclaimer, this video is for entertainment purposes only. This is just my opinion. I don't know if the lawyer and the family were like, let's just like kill him or something so we don't have to go through like trial. I don't know, you guys. I don't know. I'm just saying, like, is it possible that his family is like, let's just kill him? I don't know. I don't know. I'm just saying it doesn't make any sense. The whole thing doesn't make any sense. Is he dead? I keep hearing from spirit that he's dead. He's crossed over. Who killed him? How did he die? How is it possible that they know that this was due to a suicide gunshot to his head? Because why didn't they just say that when they discovered his skeletons and his jawbone? They could have just been like, yeah, we see a fucking hole in his skull from a fucking bullet. Why was that not disclosed? It doesn't take you 2 months to figure that out. So they found him October 20th, and this was just released like in November. It took them a month to figure out that there was a gunshot to his head. Anyways, this case pisses me off. I always get super angry. Everything gets always fucked up. I always get blocked reading it. My video got deleted. I don't even know how my video got deleted. It's literally insane. It was sitting in my fucking hard drive. It wasn't even downloaded to my desktop. Sometimes I leave it in my, like, in my downloads, and sometimes I put it in my desktop, right, to upload it into YouTube. I don't know. I do, like, different things. It's gone. Gone. Vanished. So anyways, I'm just telling you guys what happened, and I'm really sorry you guys didn't have a video for Wednesday, Thursday. It really sucks. The other thing that I'm really pissed off about that every fucking time I do a video, YouTube like reviews it for like 24 hours, and then you guys don't get a chance to see it at 5 o'clock, and then I have to wait another 24 hours before I can like publish it. So I have to start doing these videos literally like a day or two like early on, in case YouTube is gonna be like, oh, this can't be monetized, or, you know, flagged, it's inappropriate, because, like, you know, the title is the most famous, like, serial killer, or, you know, he killed his sister in cold blood, or whatever the situation is, right? So I have to do these videos like ahead of time, because that's why I don't put any photos, that's why I don't put any video, I don't put anything that's going to be incriminating for me, for YouTube. It's going to be like, oh, it's inappropriate. So I don't put any of that. It's just my stupid face talking, right? So, I mean, my face is not stupid, it's cute. Anyways, so I need to do these videos, you know, like ahead. So then if YouTube is going to be like, oh yeah, flagged, and then they have to review it, like manually review it. So I have to do that. And I have a very cool video for you guys from Monday. So for Monday, I have a really cool freaking video. This is about a woman that suffered from demonic possession, and the Catholic priest that performed the exorcisms on her became very well known in the United States, and basically he got like recognition for it and stuff, and it's pretty fucking crazy. So I'm gonna do that video for you guys for Monday. I love you guys so much. I'm so sorry this happened, but I cannot control supernatural interference. You know what I mean? If they want to come in and fuck my shit up, they're gonna come in and fuck my shit up. So I love you guys. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Definitely let me know your thoughts down below, and give this video a thumbs up, you guys. The channel is growing. I love you guys. Thank you for being here. I appreciate it. If you guys want to follow my other channels, I have, my second channel is Beauty Vlogs with Ellie. I do talk about my makeup and hair and skin and all that for all the girls that are interested. I have, my third channel is Tarot Messages with Ellie. I do collective energy readings. And then my fourth channel is Spirit Box Sessions with Ellie, where I'm going to start doing paranormal investigations, and I'm going to go to haunted locations and do paranormal videos. And then I'm going to do also Spirit Box Sessions and all of that. and it's going to be really, really neat. I have a lot of things that I want to do for 2022, so we're going to make it happen. Love you guys. I'll see you guys Monday in my next video. Bye.